Shalom, Rastafari, Rastafari disciples, Sembet Salam, my name Alonso, Ine, name. And we're not going to be so much as lecturing, rather sharing. And the name of this presentation, as you can see, is Radius, and we're going to go into that a little further on. And so let us begin by thanking Jah for a good beginning, and that he may bless I and I with a good end, of course. But let us go to Exodus chapter 17, verses 11 through 12. And this is concerning all Rastafari. The Exodus is very important, as I and I have come to grips, come to understand. So, it says here, okay, here we go. It says, and it came to pass when Moses held up his hands, that Israel prevailed. And when he let his hands down, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon. And Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. So what am I trying to get to? We need to help each other out. We need to balance the weight. We need to rightly align ourselves so that Rastafari is going on the forward in a straight line. And there's not too much weight on one man's shoulders. You know, Jethro interceded and he mediated. He was in the middle and helped out. With that, we must equally distribute Rastafari weight in order for I and I to stay afloat, keep that buoyancy, and not reach the vessel's burden, you know. And by doing so, we can fulfill this. We can fulfill Getachin Yesu's cup by each one of I's inputting and sharing the I's piece of Jesus Christos to fulfill the body, as you can see. And this will all link at the end. This will link architecturally with the radius 3.14, golden mean, sacred geometry, the Passover, it's all interconnected. Now let us go to Exodus chapter 23, verse 5. If thou see the ass of him that hateth thee lying under his burden, this means he can't take it no more. The vessel limit is, he's at his carrying capacity, basically. And wouldest forbear to help him, thou shalt surely help with him. We gotta help. If we're gonna help even them that hateth thy and I, are we not supposed to even help I and I? You know, we really got to consider this. You know, if we're to help even those that hateth I and I, we definitely got to do a lot more for each of the eyes. So let us go on. If you guys have any, I'm sorry, if you brethren and sistren have any questions, any opinions, ideas, you go to the Yahoo groups. I'm listed as militant first. See, the goal here is we're trying to balance Rastafari and keep a straight line, not lack any faith or anything. See, this is a sea of waves of faith and then doubt. And so we don't want that. We want to keep in line at a straight radius or diameter. In a perfect circumference, or anyway, so this is even kind of how the plagues, Pharaoh, the battle between Pharaoh and Jah Rastafari, Yahweh, Eloheinu. You see, Pharaoh was messing with our doubt, so that's why we're going up and down, up and down. We believed, we faith, and then we doubted, and so we must rid ourselves of such things. We must keep straight and go on. And so it's funny because Pharaoh, the whole force of Pharaoh, was using its power of persuasion to cause doubt within Nineveh. Because see, what's at stake is Pharaoh's arrogance, not willing to conform to divine order, and Pharaoh's occultic, artistic magic. And they don't want the rest of the eyes, well, the rest of the sheep to find out, to know the truth behind their magic skills. Now, this is an ellipsis, which is defined as a shortcoming, a short falling. And so, falling short, I mean, sorry. I want to let I and I know that do your thing. Whatever it is you do, do it in the name of Jah Rastafari and share with I and I. Regardless if you're a cook, if you garden, if you're in construction, if you like cars, everything within Jah creation is united, is one. And so everything will be linked, interlinked. You know, I've said before, one is the ultimate, the greatest number. There's nothing more than one. You know, two, three, four, five, six, all of that is a division of one. So let's keep it at one. And it's important that I and I communicate, I and I share ideas, perspectives, and points of view. The ellipses here, it causes a certain perspective and a certain point of view. So we must share. You see, if you rightly align in Jah axis, you're gonna get to see more. But this ellipsis gives you a limited perspective. But if we all input our personal piece of Jesus Christos, we will fulfill the cup and get the complete view. And I just want to motivate I and I to share, because the answer is within I and I. Sometimes all it takes is for another I to be like, hey, well, this looks like this. Oh, and that will enlighten some of the eyes to conclude facts and truths that we're missing from the puzzle, from the body, from the whole. Missing just because of that little piece of Jesus Christos. And so we're going to go into a little bit of architecture and the cross. And I want to, so you guys, so brethren and sistren can get a better idea of some of the things mentioned in this next section. You can visit YouTube's, and I'd recommend that you watch Ethiopia and the History Not Seen. And then the cross art form of Ethiopia, which is really good. I highly recommend that. And so, let me read a. This is found in Ethiopia papyrus scripts. If anybody knows the exact text, go ahead and let me know. I'd be really thankful. It says here, on the cross alone I do depend. It is my fortress and my strength. The cross, light of the blind, savior of the whole world. Cross above all things. Cross above the enemy. Cross, spear and shield of the church. Cross, the martyr's crown. Cross, refuge of the poor. Cross, ankle of the afflicted. Cross, virtue of the just. Cross, strength and power of the weary. Cross, making the dumb speak. Cross, ear of the deaf and faith of the saints. Cross, guide to the blind. Cross, wood of life. Cross, wood of salvation. Cross, calm of the sea. Cross, bread of the hungry. Cross, fountain of the thirsty. Cross, clothing of the naked. Cross, the rod that struck Satan. Hallelujah. Rastafari. Cross, my faith. Hallelujah. Cross, my light. My hope. Cross, my succor. Cross, my grace. The cross was made, and the high was made low, and the low was raised up. Yes, I. The reason I read that is because the cross is very important in Ethiopia. I believe that was a daily prayer or meditation. The cross unites everything. Everything is one. We must accept that as is to be what is. So let us go to Exodus chapter 31, verses 1 through 5, I believe. Says here, and the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "See, I have called by name Bezalel, the son of Uri, the son of Hur, of the tribe of Judah, and I have filled him with the spirit of Jah, in wisdom and in understanding and in knowledge and in all the manner of workmanship, to devise cunning works, to work in gold and in silver and in brass, and in the cutting of stones to set them, and in carving of timber, to work in all manners of workmanship." Now, the working of gold, carving of stone, all manner of workmanship, tribe of Judah, Moa Ambesazeem Negera Yehuda, Ethiopia. I mean, come on, there's not much else to say. And these images are just an example and proof in itself that film will really help art form, cross art form of Ethiopia. You could see it in the imperial crowns and all the jewelry, as you can see, fulfillment of Exodus chapter 31 verses 1 through 6, I believe, or 1 through 5. Let it be known, and I say, and carving, I mean, you want to say that aliens did this? Whatever. So, I also want to get into the architecture. You see, they want to say that, oh, the Portuguese had some influence in Gondar, that these people had influence here, and those people, that's all nonsense, you know? And there's proof of this within the structures themselves, which they themselves link with the radius and the authorization code of Gedachin Yesus, of the Passover, the instructions of Yahweh. Everything is encoded in I building, and it represents I freedom since the beginning. You see all everything. You can notice every Ethiopian structure from Lake Tana to Debre Damo to Lalibela to Aksum, Addis Ababa, Amba Mariam. I mean, even I bet you Magdala before, and you know, St. Mary of Zion, Church, Haile Selassie Chapel, everything. It's interlinked. They're all basically constructed around the Ark, and they have similar. The towers, the circumcised openings in the windows. We have the monkey head sticking out. This is all rock. These are not needed, but they were placed there for a reason. See, they wanna emphasize the building structure, the circumcision, the crowning round about the altar of incense, I believe. There is to be a crown roundabout. Once again, the arcs. These structures right here, the crosses, these structures are unnecessary, yet they're there for a significant purpose. Establishing our freedom. I mean, well, testifying to I freedom. The monkey heads, once again, up here, which obviously do not need to be there architecturally to support any roofing. And then some are rectangle or square shape, other buildings are round, others are hexagon, octagon, but it's all perspective. That ellipsis causes I to see certain things, you know, the square and the circle being 360 degrees, well, gives you an idea of this. Depending on perspective, you see round, you see or you see Solomon's temple and the towers up in front, and then in the altar of incense, I believe it says something, and on top there's four horns and a crown of gold round about. You know, those, that sounds like the castles and or fortresses in Gondar. You know, as you can see, crown round about. The monkey heads once again sticking out. You can see the circumcised and the... Now, rightly dividing, parting the sea, or parting I and I troubles. You see, we need to maintain balance so that we could stay afloat and walk across dry land. Israel hoy, sema am lakachen egsiab her, and egsiab her newa shema. So, parting of our troubles, if we stay rightly aligned and get that chin, Jesus Christ is our God and Father, you know, Abba Kedus, Kedamawi, Hailis, Lassi, Negushin, I guess. We're going to run out of tape, so I'm going to have to, oh my bad, we still got a little bit of time. And so, the parting of the seas can be interpreted as, let's go on to this next image so we can... So what parted the sea? An east wind, right? So here I and I is at the deepest, darkest time of I and I. And what happens, surely enough, a self-sustaining, self-supported fire, burning bush, which is, you know, self-sustaining comes along, an east wind. Let's not be blown away with any wind of doctrine. Rather, let's accept the east wind in the form of His Majesty, in the character, in this time, which is also Moses' job. He's not here to show the Israelites any special divine magic. These things weren't out of this world, we could say. He was here to testify to the times that we were in. And so, in the times, the character, he was here to testify to the character of the times. And if you testify to the right time, align to the right time, then you disclose Jah Rastafari, you disclose God. And so, East Wind, the doctrine of His Imperial Majesty, coming in, bringing salvation in the name of Jesus Christus. Has anyone done that? No. You know, you would think even the evildoers will be like, hey, I guess I'll just say I come in the name of Jesus Christus and everyone's going to accept me. No, nobody except for His Majesty comes and brings salvation. So, sign of the times, so you can know what time it is and the character of the times. So he be His Majesty, you know, for this time being. Let us submerge ourselves, not drown, submerge, then come back up in Scripture. Let us not read a verse here, a verse there. Let us completely swim in Scripture. And this is also a beginning to the tabernacle. Description of the tabernacle. You see, Jesus first was tried by fire, right? I mean, as soon as he was baptized, he was sent to, the Spirit sent him to temptation 40 days, 40 nights. That's interesting. Moses was up in the mount 40 days, 40 nights. It's like the burning of fire, the temptation is first, and then you're baptized. And the cleansing in the Word. So we're going to run out of tape here.